Welcome to Marketecture, where you can get smart fast with in-depth interviews of leading technology vendors. I'm Mike Shields, and I'm here with Mike Follett. He's the CEO of Lumen. Hey, Mike, thanks for being here.
Hey, Mike, nice to meet you.
Let's start with the big, important, maybe easy question, but one that's very crucial. What does your company do, Mike?
Lumen is an attention technology company, and we use attention data to optimize advertising for outcomes. So our mission in life is to help our clients make more money or create more memories amongst consumers. And we use everything we know about visual attention to help them go and do that.
How did it start, and what was the idea, and then what have you built since?
Well, everything starts with the eye tracking. So we've developed some proprietary software that turns your phone or your computer's webcam into an eye tracking camera. That means that we can understand not just what people could see, if things were viewable or not, but what people actually do look at if they're viewed.
So a web page comes up and you can't, the assumption was everything was viewable, everyone saw everything, but you can actually, your software tells someone where the eyes actually go.
Exactly that. That when an ad is viewable, you often say you've got an opportunity to see it, an OTS. But there's a big difference between opportunity and actually doing stuff. So what we can measure is whether or not anyone looked at this ad or not. Not just if the ad was viewable, but if it was actually looked at. And so that's our core proprietary technology.
And how does that work, Mike? I'm sorry, you don't have nodes in anybody's eyeballs. How does that
work? No, not at all. What we do is we go and recruit panels of people around the world, in the States, in the US, but also we've been doing lots of work in Indonesia, Argentina, Brazil, anywhere you can think of. We can recruit people and we say, hey, do you want to be part of an eye tracking panel? We'll pay you money. It's all above board, first party data, privacy compliant. And people download our software onto their phones or onto their desktop computers. And we pay them good money to allow us to track what it is that they look at and what is it they ignore when they're online.
Okay.
That's the primary use of the eye tracking, to go and collect these really big data sets of attention data. And from that, we can see that there are vast differences in things being viewable and viewed, and massive great differences by the format and by the website or app that's used. An ad on one website might get tons of attention, but the same ad on a different website might get a very little amount of attention or no attention at all. An ad on one platform might do really well, but the same ad on a different platform in a different format might be ignored. And that's the core of our data, understanding the reality of attention and the differences between ad formats, publishers, and platforms.
And how big is your panel?
So we have panels around the world. We have a panel in the States of 1,000 people and a panel in the UK of 1,000. And those people give us data every day. So they're the largest eye tracking panels in the world, and they collect data all the time. But in addition, we can set up more temporary panels around the world. And to date, we've had around 412,000 people collect data from them. So we are sitting on by far the largest attention data set in the world. But while it's the biggest data set in the world, we've got millions and millions of data points. It is only millions and not billions or trillions. Our panels are big and our data set is huge, but the internet is much, much bigger.
Mm-hmm.
And so we don't use the panels necessarily to report on ad A being seen in City B or whatever, or saying, going to Chevy and saying, we reckon that 17% of the country has actually seen your ad, because the data sets that we've got are simply not designed to give that sort of information. Instead, what we do is we use this enormous great data set to create a predictive model of attention, a mathematical model. And this model is wildly scalable, because what it does is it looks at the viewability characteristics of these different ads. It says that ads on platform A always get noticed, ads on platform B only 50% of the time, or whatever. When an ad is on screen for a long time, it's going to get more attention than when an ad is on screen for a short amount of time, and so on. It takes all of those viewability characteristics, the domain, the dwell time on page and things like that, and then it can use that data to predict how likely people are to look at the ads and how long they're going to look at it for.